Hi everyone, this is Coach Henderson, here to talk to you a little bit about our track and field unit. Some people think joining the track team means you just run in an oval around the track. This is true for some of the events, but there's so much more. There are jumpers, throwers, hurdlers, and vaulters, as well as runners. The runners are divided into different events based on their strengths. Fast runners do the sprints, whereas distance runners have great endurance, which is the ability to run for a long time without burning out. For this assignment, the focus will be on the distance races. The distance events in track and field range from the 800-meter race up to a 3,200-meter race. Outdoor tracks are about 400 meters. That's once around. Athletes running the 800-meter race will run around the track twice. Another distance race is the 1,600-meter, which is four times around. This race is about a mile long. The 3,200-meter race is eight times around the track and is about 2 miles long. Let's go to the senior high school to see the track. Here we are. This is where the Rush Henrietta Royal Comets have their track meets. In seventh grade, you can start competing for the school. Today, I'm going to run the 1600 meter to show you what it is like. Here I go. I don't need no reason, don't be control. I fly so high, no ceiling when I'm in my zone. Cause I got that sunshine in my pocket, got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my. I'm going to have to pace myself because I have to run around this track four times to do the 1600 meter. I don't want to start too fast and I don't want to start too slow. I have to know my body and I have to know what I'm capable of. And that takes practice. It's a good idea to think about your breathing as you're running, making sure you're not breathing too heavy and too fast. It's also good to think about your running form. Make sure your arms are to the side of your body and they're low and loose. You don't want them to cross in front of you as you're running. Sometimes when I get tired, I find that my shoulders are way up high close to my ears, and I have to remind myself to drop them down. So one lap is done. I have three to go. Don't worry, I'm not going to bore you and make you watch the whole thing. I'm going to fast forward it and skip it so you don't have to see every step of the way. All those things I shouldn't do, but you did. I'm approaching the end of my third lap. That means there is one to go. When I'm thinking about pacing myself, I know that I'm probably going to want to pick up my pace at the end of the race because I'll probably most likely be challenged by some of the other runners and I want to have a little bit of a kick left at the end. Got this feeling in my body. Can't stop the feeling.